All right, good morning all. Welcome to Chef DiGiusto's at home cooking lab. So today we're going to keep going with shellfish and seafood. I got a list of them. I think they're, you know, there's so many different ways. My most exciting one is showing you guys alligator fishing and what they use, how they cook it. Today we're going to start with mollusks. Well, not mollusks, but bivalves pretty much. So let me share screen with you. And what I mean by bivalves is, where did that picture go? Oh, here we go. Let me move some things around here. Let me make sure I'm sharing my sound. What I mean by bivalves is the two-sided or two-shelled organisms with like two-shelled organisms with the muscle in the middle. Okay, so here you go. These are mollusks right here. So one or two hard shells. Univalves are abalone. That's what you're seeing. I think those are abalone. Yeah, that's the inside. And then bivalves are your clams, oysters, mussels, and scallops. This is a really good picture of a scallop right here. So like the Shell gas station shell. The reason I want to kind of break these down, because they're all so different. You know what I mean? Like you look at a picture of a fish, that's nothing like the picture of a scallop. So it's a completely different animal. It's like saying, oh, chicken and beef are the same thing. No, they're not. Okay, here's where I added my stuff. Okay, so looking at this picture, these are different bivalves, okay? You got your scallops. This is a clam right here. This one is called a I forget the name of this one. Or no, this is a gooey duck or something like that. Basically, that's a clam. It's a giant clam. And people will eat this entire tongue-looking thing that comes out of it. It just depends on how they cook it. These are oysters. So the ones with the real crazy wavy shells are typically oysters. And they all live differently. Like clams typically will kind of bunch up together, you know, in one general area. These clams will kind of climb along and eat stuff. Like I think they soak up, they like absorb nutrients through the little tubey thing. Mussels, there's a whole different, I'm gonna kind of break these down on different slides for you guys. Mussels are basically attached to something, almost like a barnacle. They're not barnacles, but they kind of adhere to a fixed structure. And oysters grow in beds. Okay, so what we're gonna talk about today is scallops, because it's like one of my all-time favorite seafoods. This is a picture of pan-seared divers scallops. Okay, there's two different types of scallops. There's diver scallops, which are, you know, the ocean scallops, which are big. And then there's bay scallops, which are these little dudes right here. The bay scallops, and they're cooked different ways just because of how they're packed. Okay, so pan-seared diver scallops, the way they sell these are basically a lot of seafood is sold like this, especially shrimp is the most common one people think of. They sell them by weight, volume of amount of quantity or amount of, you know, protein per pound. So I know it sounds weird. So say you go to the store and you buy 16, 20 shrimp. That means there's 16 to 20 shrimp per pound. So when you think of 16 to 20, you're like, oh man, it's about an ounce a piece. You know, those are like pretty decent sized shrimp. That scale goes all the way to I think they're 10 12s or something like that, or 11 13s, which are really big shrimp. Then there's like under 10s, which means you have under 10 shrimp per pound. I think that's the biggest one. I don't know. I'll have to check, but those are big. And then they have like 70 90s where they're little tiny ones. So there's like could be 90 per pound, which means they're real small. Same thing with scallops. They're packed according to 1 pound and how many are in it. So if you get U10s, that means they're going to be under 10 scallops per pound. So they're going to be really big. And that's probably what these are. These are like the restaurant scallops. And you're going to see why these things are so expensive. So bay scallops, I think, are easier to harvest, where they can just like dredge the bottom with a net and pull up all these shells, take the scallop out. These ones are a lot cheaper. And the applications are mainly just pastas. You can fry them. You don't really want to try to dry these things out and sear them, because what they do is they pack these usually frozen, or they have some sort of, like, when you, they don't have these, they're not dry when you get them. Okay. They're usually, you can't usually get these things fresh around here, these little bay scallops. These ones are dry packed, where they're just packed in a can. And there's no solution, there's nothing on them. They're completely dry. If you buy them wet, I mean, they have so much liquid in them, it's hard to even get this color when you cook them. Anywho, we'll keep going. So this picture I put in there because this is how you catch these things. Like, you have to go down, dive for them, and catch them. So real quick, I'm going to show you guys this video. I found a video where this guy does this. Where'd it go? I had the video where this guy does this. Where'd he go? It's on here. I'm sorry. Here it is. Okay. So the reason they cost so much, it's they don't have a farm where they raise these things. So watch this. So this guy is swimming, right? He's snorkeling, probably in like 6 to 8 feet of water, and he has to find the scallops. These are called diver scallops. So he's got a bag with them, like a just a net bag, and you have to swim around and learn how to spot these things. So, and like, see how that one is opening and closing? That means it's alive. And that's how they swim. They go, and they'll get away from you. They're not very slow, but yeah. So you have to just keep swimming and keep your eyes open, because they kind of mask themselves in there. And be careful, they will pinch. But the larger the shell on these things typically means a bigger scallop. So yeah, you see how he has to do this? So if you think about it, if this guy does this, if you've ever gone snorkeling, it's a very strenuous, like, swimming alone, I think, is probably, see how that thing moves? Swimming alone is very strenuous on your body. I mean, you use every muscle in your body to swim. So he's basically swimming for a long period of time to catch these things. And see, the more he goes after them, they keep swimming away. So you can imagine his boat's probably well far 100 yards behind him by the time he catches his basket full. And that's a full, you know, that's half a day of work, okay? That's why they cost so much. So these things are roughly, I would say now they're probably over 20, maybe $30 a pound. They're pretty expensive. So, and that's why they're expensive, because you have to find them, clean them. They don't send them to you typically unless you're in the ocean. If you're in Indiana, you have to pay for somebody to clean these, shuck them, pack them in a can safely, and then ship them to you. So they're pretty expensive, and they're very perishable. So when they come to you, they're usually in a box packed with ice, and this looks like a paint can, just crammed inside there. But yeah, so that's how they catch these things. Pretty amazing. So need to keep going? Yeah. All right. But yeah, that's, I don't know, I thought it was pretty cool. Okay, so. But now she feels like a remora. Do you see how quick they are? Alright, so that's the first video. I want you guys to see that, because when you go to a restaurant and you have to pay, you know, $30 for a plate and only have, like, oh, I got four of these things on here. Think of how this is caught. It's not like a cow that just walks around the backyard and somebody butchers it and gives you a steak, which is still very expensive. But these people have to go out and catch these things by hand underwater. You know, that's kind of a hard job. All right, let's go back to our PowerPoint. Did I just do that? There's a part on how to clean these things, which is right here. So they have these giant scallop shells. You can see how big these are. And then this video is how to cook them. And it's one of my favorite things to cook at restaurants. So when I cooked in restaurants, I was typically the saute guy because that was like my favorite thing to do, where I made every single, and that's why you guys at school right now are cooking everything short order in pans, because that's how restaurants work. Like when we did mac and cheese that day, restaurants I worked at, when you got an order for pasta, you did that. Like you had to cook that to order. And it's not very, you know, and if you think of going to like Olive Garden or one of these restaurants, Olive Garden probably doesn't do like that, but at some of these restaurants, if you're the guy cooking pasta, there's probably two or three of you just cooking spaghetti and meatballs and stuff, and you have to cook every single dish like that. So it takes a while. Anywho, let's go. Why is this not working? Oh, crapola. All right, let me go back to this one. Oh, here we go. Basically, you want to break this seal because that thing's clammed together like this. And typically, these are alive. Like all shelf, like bivalves like this are alive when you get them. So you open this thing up. Bring the music back. That's it. So when you open that thing up, it almost looks like, it's similar to what clams and stuff look like. They have the, looks like lips almost around the outside of it. And then the main heart of that is the muscle that you want. Okay, that's the best part. And then it has this little abductor they usually keep on there that adheres it to its shell. And like he put, classical way of serving this is just wash the shells and serve it back in the shell after it's cooked. Because you can see that first part that he pulled out, that the lip, little flangey looking thing on the outside, that probably does not cook up very well. Like, and I'm going to be honest with you, every time I've ever seen scallops, they're cleaned already and they send them to us because they will not last very long if they send them. They're very perishable. Like they don't even ship those things away from the coast without being processed. And processed, all they do is they, what he just did, and they pack them, okay? This part is how to cook these. This is one, this is just a classic, let me move this. This thing's real annoying. This is one of the classic ways. So let's play this. Not having good luck with this computer today. All right, where are we at? Here we are. Okay, current slide. Maybe this one will play out. There we go.
Hi everyone and welcome back to Chef Seats. Today I'm going to show you how to master the art of seared scallops at home. No more needing to waste your time and money going to these fine dining foofy restaurants when, you know what, I'm going to teach you to be your own chef right here. And just like always, only thing you're going to need are a few simple ingredients. So let's get started. Now scallops have two sides to them. They have a seared side and an unseared side. Let me explain right now. So there is a bottom piece which is smaller than a top, and what we want to do is sear the larger top piece. So let me show you one more. There you go. You see that top part is larger, and then you'll see on the bottom it's smaller. Well, what you like to do is sear the top ones. This helps with creating a really nice presentation, and that's pretty much the only trick of what restaurants do opposed to maybe at your own home. And of course, nice amount of seasoning, a little bit of salt. I'm not going to put any pepper on this. I don't want the pepper to burn. We could pepper it later on if you like, but this is totally fine without it. Remember, both sides are just as important. So let's get this pan out of the way and let's get cooking. So put our pan on a heat, high heat of course, and toss a little bit of oil in a pan. Now what I like to do is get this oil ripping hot, just on the verge of smoking. You see how that is? Now a large side of the scallop going down. Make sure that you don't overload your pan with too many scallops because you want to keep the pan nice and hot. Place the scallop in and make sure it's nice and firm to the bottom. Now just let it set for a little bit. Now this is total real time on how to cook the scallop, and you know, you notice that I had four of them before. I'm only going to do two per pan. I don't want to overcrowd the pan like I just said, and you're going to see this nice caramelization on the bottom. It's going to get really nice and brown. You can see on the bottom of the edges right there, it's starting to get it. And yes, this is high heat. See a little bit of color. So now what I like to do is start basting this right here so that we're going to cook it one side 90% of the time and just baste it with the hot oil. There we go. Just keep on basting away, keep basting away. It's very important that you place this oil away from you. This is very hot, so be very careful at this moment, please. Now, when I buy my scallops, I go to the local fish market and I just buy it right there. I don't buy them at the local supermarket because, you know, you're never too sure of the exact quality of that. So just make sure when you're buying seafood that you're basting and basting and basting.
All right. So he's pretty much doing how I was kind of teaching you guys for a while. You always want to, this is a pan sear, okay? He said he doesn't sear both sides, but that's what he's doing right now, so I don't know why. He's not why he said that, but that is how you do this. Okay. And what he's doing now, add the butter, add some fresh thyme. It'll start to crackle and pop and all those natural oils come out of the the thyme. And then you just baste these things and you're going to see that nice hard sear right there. These things have so much sugar in them that it's the most sweet seafood you'll ever taste. It's weird that something that lives in salt water can taste so sweet. It amazes me. But that is what you're looking for. And I don't know why he said, this is the presentation side. That's what he was getting at. So you do sear both sides of these. You don't just sear one. And then you present the large open face on top. That's basically what it is. But yeah, you get that nice crust. And then this sauce that's in the pan, just put right on there. You know, that's pan sauce. If you want to do something a little different, you could just throw a little cream on in that pan and let it reduce first, you know, just till it bubbles and then pour that on top. Maybe some lemon segments, whatever you want. But these things are so ridiculously good. It's hard to describe how good they are. And then honestly, when you go to the grocery store or you go to your fish market, fishmonger, you'll probably pay like $2 a piece for these things, maybe $3 each. So it's not something you want to just go serve every day. I mean, they're pretty expensive. So let's keep going. Okay.
Hi everyone and welcome back to Chef's.
Okay, so this is the last one I want to show you guys. These are different presentations of those scallops, okay? So see if you can pick out. Two pictures are bay scallops and two pictures are ocean scallops. Remember the difference? That's right. Ocean scallops, and this is I saw this earlier. Remember, ocean's big, bay is little. So ocean scallops are these big ones, right here, right here. These are classic, so this is like an Italian style. You have some probably broccoli rabe, pan-seared scallops served on top of risotto, which is a very creamy rice, which we'll go over when we get into starches. You could put your brown butter right on top of that with a little bit of cream. And it's ridiculously tasty. If you want a little bit of crunch, that's probably why they put the broccoli rabe in there. They probably just blanched it and kind of served it al dente, so you have a little crunch with each bite. These pan-seared, that looks like a lemon beurre blanc, some grapefruit segments on the outside of here, and a nice pepper crust on there. That looks pretty. And it's probably, If you went to a restaurant, this is probably $25, something like that. These are bay scallops. This picture up top is basically how I learned about scallops. My whole family on my dad's side is from Boston, Massachusetts. And you eat a ton of seafood out there because they have, it's cold water and seafood is plentiful. Like when I was growing up, we'd go out there and we'd go down to the bay and you could go to these little shacks, restaurants, and buy like sandwiches like this, or just buy, they give you this brown paper bag filled with fried scallops. And you didn't have sauce. They were just so freaking good because they were crispy and just sweet inside. I didn't even know what I was eating, but my dad's like, eat this. And I would just pop like the whole bag. I mean, they were so delicious. So that's a traditional, and they do that with whole belly clams and stuff too, like fried clams. Well, oh, just, it's candy. So, and then this bottom picture is bay scallops, and it looks like a pasta dish, maybe. I don't know. I can't really tell what those things are. They almost look like peaches, but they're really good for, they don't get a ton of color on them because the way they pack these, they're wet packed. So you can, it's hard to even get these things dry enough to sear them. So it's more of a finishing, throw these in at the end kind of thing. And they'll cook pretty quick. Like even from frozen, these things cook quick. So they're good for soups, salads, that kind of stuff where you can just steam them. Oh, you don't want to steam them. You want to like saute them. If you're putting them in a cold salad, you almost want to like let them thaw out and then saute them real quick. They're not going to get a lot of color, but they'll be cooked through. And yeah, that's what you're kind of looking for there. But they're really good for soups as well. Like we use these in soups all the time, like a bouillabaisse. We could put some in that jambalaya, you know, it just depends on what you're making, but they're so small, they're really delicate and they're good for that type of application. All right. Let's see how we are good on time. All right. So yeah. And this kind of gets into shucking clams, but this is kind of generalized for a lot of things. So whenever you get these bivalves, you always want to scrub the outside of the shell, remove all sand and grit. When we get to mussels, I'll show you, they have a beard where they basically they'll grab onto something and adhere to it, and then that's where they live, and we'll see. We'll go over that more. Always wear a cut-resistant glove. That's what these things are here. I have boxes of these at school if we ever get back. Hold the clam in protected hand, and then clam knives are different from oyster knives. So this is a very thin, strong blade. Sometimes they're curved a little bit and they're made to stick into here, and you want to crack this thing open and you twist. It's the twisting of this which gets it open. Did they show the next part? No. So you twist this thing open and then you want to clean these things out, okay? Especially if you're going to eat them raw. But if you're going to eat these raw, you really need to like, that's a whole different process. So if you're serving these on a half shell, you really need to like soak these things alive in salted water with a little bit of cornmeal in it. And you basically want it to filter through the good water to get rid of the crap that's inside of it. Cause some of these, you open them up and they'll be full of mud. So that's a whole different story. We'll show that in another one. But anyway, this is kind of similar to the scallops. Like you saw, you want to break it at the hinge, take your knife, go around the outside of it, open it up, be real careful because the juice inside there is called the liquor, and that's not like liqueur, but it's called the liquor of the shell, and that's got a lot of flavor to it. So a lot of times when people will eat these raw, they want that liquor. So you serve it like that with a little bit of juice it came with inside. So I could go on for days. But anywho, I'll have some questions for you guys. That is the whole video on scallops. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.